Hi, welcome to the next section of this course. In this section, we will check out the usage of the abstract keyword. So in this section, in the first video, we will explore what is an abstract class in Java. And then we will check out what is the abstract method. So let us start with our video 1. That is abstract class in Java. Well, the abstract class can be defined as a class that is declared as abstract. Now, you cannot create the object of the abstract class. That is, the abstract class cannot be instantiated. And in the end, the abstract class may or may not contain the abstract methods. Now, what do we mean by the abstract methods? We will check it out in the next video. So here, back to our IntelliJ IDE, let us first explore what is the abstract class. So down below here, I will define the rules to define the abstract class. So down below here, let us define the class of animal. Now to declare this class animal as abstract, you have to use the abstract keyword. So once you do it, we have just created the class as abstract. So we have fulfilled our criteria number 1. Fine. Now next, you can't create the object of the abstract class. That is, within our main function, you cannot use the new keyword followed by the animal constructor to create the object. It will simply show you the error. Animal is abstract, can't be instantiated. So here it is not allowed. Fine. So right now let us comment it. Perfect. Now within our abstract class, you can actually declare any normal function. Such as, let us declare the function of run. And let us define our print statement. So once this method is executed, it will simply print out animal is running. Perfect. Now what about the third one? That is, the abstract class may or may not contain the abstract methods. Now what do we mean by the abstract methods? We will check it out in the next video. So this video was all about the abstract class. So in the next video, let us check out our abstract method.